我翻译的时候比较喜欢站在这边。
When I'm translating, I like to be on this side.
这个不是一个怪癖。
This is not a bad habit.
No. 因为我的左耳不太好。
That's perfect because my right hearing aid is better.
Really?
yeah, it is.
因为我的耳朵很久以前因为感冒病毒，我没有发现，所以影响到我的听力。
Because a long time ago, I had a cold, and I had an ear infection. I didn't discover that, so my left ear is not as good as my right ear.
所以呢，我帮朱牧师翻译的时候呢，我喜欢用我好的耳朵，可以听到他在讲什么。
So when I translate for Pastor Steve, we can. I like to be on this side, so I can use my good ear.
所以既然他的右耳，那我们今天这样刚刚好，对吧？
对，刚刚好。
Okay, all right. Okay.
We have an audiologist now in the house.
Yeah, 因为我们现在教会有一位听力专家，我或许应该去看这位听力专家，看看我的听力如何了。
Yes, we shall.
好，我们从五月底开始讲希伯来书。
We started preaching through Hebrews at the end of May.
今天是我们希伯来书的最后一堂讲道了。
And today is our last sermon for the book of Hebrews.
在这段时间，我们看希伯来书这位作者他如何的写信给一群应该是在罗马的犹太背景的基督徒。
So we see in this during this time how the author Hebrews wrote to the audience who were Jewish Christians background living in the city of Rome.
这群犹太基督徒呢，他们因为经历了很多的患难，有一些人呢，他们开始动摇了。
And so these Christians in Rome, because of the persecutions they were going through, they were starting, some of the Christians started to be shaky in their faith.
有一些人他们觉得或许我应该再回到我原来的信仰。
And so some of the Christians, Jewish Christians thought, maybe I should return back into Judaism.
或许很多人在患难中觉得这个上帝对我没有帮助。
Or some of the Christians may be thinking, you know, in the midst of the trials and tribulation, God is not much help.
特别是我们自己在患难当中的时候，我们也有这种感觉。
And especially for us, when we're going through our own trials and tribulations, a lot of times we think the same way.
我们也会说上啊，神啊，你在哪里？
A lot of times we might even say, my God, where are you?
我们也会像耶稣说，我的神，我的神，你为什么要离弃我？
And we may perhaps we echo the Lord word of our Lord, my God, why have you forsaken me?
所以或许有一些犹太基督徒，他想，或许是不是我应该再回到我原来的那个信仰系统呢？
And so there are some of these Jewish Christians were thinking, maybe I should return back into my Jewish traditions.
所以这位希伯来书作者就写信，大大的劝勉这群基督徒，好好守住他们当初所听到的这个信仰。
Oh, so this author is writing to them, says, you know what? Hang on to the faith, to the gospel you have heard.
有的时候他太急切了，他甚至用很严厉的口气来警告这群准备离开信仰的人。
And because of the pressure, or because of the urgency of the matter, sometimes you use very strong language.To rebuke these Christians.
所以你在希伯来书可以看到整个的新约当中口气最严厉的几段经文。
And so in all of New Testament, you can find the book of Hebrews some of the sternest words against those who would depart from the faith.
你从这个严厉的口气，你可以感觉到这位作者他是如何的急切，他是如何的不希望他的群体会离开这个信仰。
And from the tone of his letter, you can see how desperate.How urgent his senses that these Christians do not leave the faith.
但是呢，这些很严厉的经节还是比较少的。他大部分呢，还是鼓励这些弟兄姐妹好好的持守真道，继续的往前走。
But overall, in this letter, the stern words are actually very few. Most of the words are actually encouragement to stay in the faith.
特别是到了第十三章的时候呢，他提出来很多实际的建议这些弟兄姐妹在他们的道德生活上，在他们的社会生活上，在他们的群体生活上，如何的活出这个信仰。
Especially in the here in chapter 13, when he opens the letter about the practical matters, how to live in your day-to-day life, how to live with your the people around you, surrounding, and also how to live in the culture in which you live.
所以呢，我们今天要读的这段圣经呢，基本上呢，他再次的勉励这些弟兄姐妹如何跟他们的领袖相处。
And so, as we open this passage, first of all, he gave a practical instruction how the people should get along with their leaders.
那这个呢，其实呢，是呼应他在第七节已经讲过的。
And this is really, in a sense, is echoing what he already said in verse 7 of chapter 13.
因为他在第七节说，从前引导你们、传神之道给你们的人，你们要想念他们，效法他们的信心，留心看他们为人的结局。
Verse 7 tells us, remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God, consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith.
所以在第七节呢，他勉励这个教会的姐妹呢，他们要想到他们以前的那些领袖。
So he's telling them to remember the leaders of the past.
这里中文的有个翻译不是太好，结局这个字，英文翻译的比较好。所以呢，这个结局呢，你不是说看这个人的下场如何，而是说你看到这个人生命他所散发出来的成果 outcome。
Yes, the English word here used the outcome, and then the idea is that you examine the past leaders, their whole way of life.
所以他们的生命所结出的果子，而不是说他的下场，因为你看很多人爱神的人，他们的下场并不是很好啊，他们的 result。
What he's telling them to do is examine the fruit of their lives, not just what happened at the end of their lives. Because the Chinese translation has a sense that it's talking about the result, meaning the toward the end of their lives, which may not always be good.
对，因为至少对我来讲，David Linhao 生病的时候，对我来讲是一个信心很大的挑战。
Because to tell you the truth, when our missionary David Lienhouse was ill, it was actually a very big challenge for my own faith.
那个时候其实我人不在 Milwaukee, 我在台湾。
Because at the time I was actually in Taiwan, not in Milwaukee.
但是我看到 Lienhouse 他录了一段，他做化疗的时候，他传了一段视像给我们。
I saw a video that he passed on, that he recorded during the process when he was going through chemo treatment.
我那个时候心里真的，很不平衡。
And actually, at the time, I was just really, my heart was really not settled.
因为呢，我那个时候一直跟神讲，我说这个人，我们有几个人会想到要有这个勇气带着自己的家人去索马利亚？
I was thinking, how many of us would have the courage to take our whole family to Somalia?
这个人带着自己的太太，带着自己年轻的小孩，到一个战火烽烟，然后这么危险的地方，献上自己的生命，献上自己的家庭。
This man took his young wife and took his young children into Somalia, which is a war zone, with the risk of his family for the sake of the gospel.
我那时候祷告，我说神啊，这个就是你给他的下场吗？
And I said to myself, Lord, is this the result that you give to him for what he has done?
我想我们每常遇到这样的情形的时候，我们都会有这样的问题，有这样的挑战。
I think, you know, when we run across situations like this all the time, we have the same kind of doubts ourselves.
但是这里希伯来书他说的不是这个，他说的是说我们要看我们先前的领袖他们的生命当中所散发出来的结果，他们的果子是怎么样的。
But this is not what the author of Hebrews is talking about. He's not talking about focusing on what happened at the end of their lives, but he's telling them to focus on the fruits that these leaders bore because of their ministry.
最近我又在读王牧师的回忆录。
Recently I've also reread Pastor Wong, the founding pastor of our church, his memoir.
云采集，在这边我再次看到，当他1974年他第一次来到 Milwaukee 的时候，他就看到这个地方的需要。
And I read in that memoir how in 1974, when Pastor Wong arrived in Milwaukee, he saw the needs here for church.
他那时候还是那个 Wheaton College 的研究生。
At the time, he was still a graduate student at Wheaton College.
但是呢，他在这他看到神要他留在这里。
And he saw, but at the time, he sensed God's calling for him to stay here in Milwaukee.
他当时有很多更好的选择。
At the time, he had a lot of better choices.
他可以回到台湾。
He could go back to Taiwan.
他可以去加拿大。
He could go to Canada.
所以呢 ，Milwaukee 是一个最不好的选择。
So Milwaukee is actually his worst choice.
但是呢，他知道神要他在这里，所以他就心甘情愿地决定留在这里。
But he knew that God was calling him here, so he just settled in his mind to stay here in Milwaukee.
一留就留了24年。
And so that's one stay became 24 years.
这个教会很大的成果是在于王牧师的忠心。
And the fruit of his labor that we see today is because of Pastor Wong's work.
所以希伯来书第七节说，我们要常常纪念先前的领袖，我们要效法他们的精神。
So when this is what the passage here says, remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God, consider the outcome of their way of life, imitate their faith.
我想这个教会在很多教会相较起来，我们这个教会是问题比较少，是比较合一的。我是说真的。
I think compared to all the churches I've experienced, I actually consider this church one of the more unified, more peaceful, that we really get along, and I mean that.
虽然我们有争吵，我们有很多的问题。
Even though we still have our fights, our disagreements, we still have a lot of problems.
但是相较之下，我觉得是因为王牧师他二十多年来，他一直的鼓励弟兄姐妹的合一，弟兄姐妹的彼此相爱，所以我们今天教会能走到这样的一个程度，是真的非常的不容易，都是要谢谢他。
And so, but I think that we have followed Pastor Wong's example of telling us to be unified, to live in harmony with one another. And this is the fruit that he himself has given to us.
所以这是希伯来书作者在第七节对弟兄姐妹的勉励。
And so this is the encouragement that the author Hebrew gives to the brothers and sisters here in verse 7.
那在第十七节呢，他就把焦点转移到现在的他们当时的教会当中的领袖了。
And now in verse 17, he puts a focus on the present leaders.
他说，在第十七节说，你们要对这些现在的领袖呢，你们要依从那些引导你们的，且要顺服。
Here it says, obey your leaders and submit to them.
但是这个依从跟顺服呢，它是有一个前提的。
The word obey and submit has an antecedent.
Has a premises.
Has a premise.
这个前提呢是建立在我们为什么要顺服，我们为什么要依从。下面有一个 for， 有一个因为，有一个理由的。
Okay. The premise is why do you need to obey? Why do you need to submit? The reason is that he himself gave us a reason. It's just the word for.
为什么呢？因为这些领导人呢，他们是为你们的灵魂时刻警醒的。
It's just that they are keeping watch over your souls.
所以换句话说呢，这个顺服引导它不是一个 blank check， 它不是说你盲目的你就随便的就听从就顺服教会的领导人。
And here here it gives us the reason. This is not a blank check. It's not a blank submission. It's not a blank obedience. They give us the reason why we need to obey.
因为今天在教会，在很多的教会，你可以看到这些非常集权、非常威权的教会，你什么？他们好像把牧师当做一个教皇一样的。
And a lot of times, because you can see that in extreme, some extreme churches where the pastor is almost is a pope.
所以呢 he can do no wrong. 他呢他说什么你就听什么。
And so that whatever he says is almost like a scripture.
但是呢其实你如果看新约的话，新约也鼓励我们，我们要有一个辨识的心，要辨识这些人所说的对不对，合乎真理。
But if you read the scripture, you know that scripture tells us that we need to have a discerning heart. We need to...Listen to what our leader says and discern that through the filter of scripture.
特别是今天在这个网络发达的时代，你上网你可以听到很多很多似是而非的言论，似是而非的讲道。
So that you know, we need to be mindful of this in this internet age, because there's a lot of truth and falsehood in the internet. There could be also true word of God, also falsehood and heresies as well.
所以我们要非常的注意，就是说这个顺服领导，我们为什么要顺服？因为他们是在看守我们的灵魂，他是在做一个忠心的牧人的职分。
And the reason, so here we need to see the reason why we need to obey, the reason why we need to submit is because the leaders are called.To keep watch over their souls, they're to be a faithful shepherd.
所以呢，这个警醒这个字呢，它原来的意思就是说保持清醒。
And the word for keeping watch is actually has this idea of staying awake.
所以就像一个牧羊人，他看羊群的时候，他呢他自己不能打瞌睡，他打瞌睡的话呢，他的羊就被狼吃掉了。
Just like a shepherd, when the shepherd is actually keeping watch over his sheep, he cannot sleep because as soon as he sleeps, the wolves will get to the sheep.
就像城墙上那个守望的军人一样，他不能打瞌睡。他打瞌睡的话，这个城就完蛋了。
And just like a soldier staying on watch at the watchtower, he cannot fall asleep because if he falls asleep, the city is doomed.
所以希伯来书作者说，请看你们这些领袖，为了你们信仰的缘故呢，他不眠不休，他为着你们的灵魂好好的看守，希望你们不要再回到往日的那种信仰状态当中。
And so he says to them, so submit to your leaders, obey them, because they're watching over your souls. They're watching you so that you do not go back to your old tradition.
所以这个是也是我们对我，这个是也是对我自己跟教会这些牧师这个的一个自己的期许，自己的勉励。
And so these words are actually an encouragement for myself and also for all the pastors and the elders of the church.
我希望我自己是一个常常可以警醒看守弟兄姐妹灵魂的人。
I want to be the pastor who's also keeping watch, constantly staying awake, keeping watch over the souls of the brothers and sisters.
我希望我不是一个警察，看像警察一样看着你们。
I hope that I am not a policeman.
我希望我是一个牧者，像看守羊群的一样看守着你们。
I hope that I am rather like a shepherd, tendering, caring, and watching over you.
然后希望弟兄姐妹对我的顺服，对我的依从，是因为我对你们灵魂的牧养，而不是因为我对你们的一个职位的关系。
So I hope as well that you will submit, you will obey me because of my love for your souls, not because of my authoritarianism.
然后呢，当我有问题的时候呢，且请你不要客气，就请你直接的跟我讲，不要辗转的说。
And so, and also as well, I want to extend this invitation. If I have a problem in my own life, please come to me, approach me, and do not be hesitate.
因为保罗在他的书信当中说，我们要彼此照顾，彼此接纳，所以这个是一个互相的这个关系。
And as Paul says in Scripture, he says, we need to carry each other's burdens. We need to accept one another. So we need to correct each other.
所以呢，弟兄姐妹的顺服是因为我的这个警醒的看守。
And so your submission, your obedience is because of my watching over your soul.
如果当我们真正的可以做到这样的地步的时候呢，就不会产生下面这个问题了。
And so if we can do this, we will prevent the problem below.
因为呢，在下面记着他说呢，他说好像那将来交账的人，你们要使他们交的时候快乐。但是呢，其实呢，原文就是说呢，你呢让他们呢带着喜乐的心这么做，他没有说让他们交账的时候喜乐。这个又是中文译本的问题。
OK.
因为英文说 let them do this with joy, right?
Right.
但是呢，那个中文是说他们交账的时候 as they give account.
OK.
所以他们中文的翻译是比较 specific 的。
OK. In the Chinese translation of this passage, it gives a sense that when they give an account before God.Let them do give this account before God with joy, which is not specific in English.
在原文当中，它是一个代名词，所以呢，它可以指两件事情，就是说呢，这个呢，就是说让这些领导人呢，将来交账的人，你们要使他们快乐。这个使他们快乐呢，有两个方面。第一个呢，就是说让他们做牧人的时候使他们快乐。
Okay.
你听懂了吗？
我 I guess stuck in 代名词。
OK， 好，我重来一遍啊。好，就说呢，这那个他说你们要这个，因为教会的是那个教会的牧人，你们要顺从他们。
Because what this passage is saying, because you are, because they are shepherds of the church, you need to submit to them.
然后呢，有一天呢，这些牧人、这些牧师，他们自己要跟神交账的。
And these pastors one day will have to give an account before God.
所以有一天你。我们有一天我们要在神面前交账的。
So one day we have to give an account before God.
就像马太福音的那个才干的比喻一样。
Just like the parable of the talent.
然后有一天我站在上帝的面前，上帝会问我。
And so one day I stand before God, God will ask me.
上帝问我说，徐成德，我把米城教会交给了你，你做了你该做的事情吗？
And he'll say to me, Daniel, I gave you Milwaukee Chinese Christian Church. Did you do what I want you to do?
所以这里说你们要顺服这些人，因为他们将来要跟在神面前交账的。
And so the author says, submit to them because they have to give an account.
然后接下来英文说 let them do this， 好像这个 this 好像不是很清楚指哪一件事情。
Yes, right.And here is English says, let them do this. This is kind of ambiguous. We're not sure what this refers to. It can refer to two things.
但是我觉得都有可能。第一个是 watch over，就是让他们带着喜乐的心来看守警醒。
This could refer to watch over, that their shepherding itself be with joy.
也就是说呢，让你教会的牧者让他们做这个看守警醒的事情的时候呢，他们是带着喜乐的心，不是带着忧伤叹息的心。所以想到他的会众，他就忧伤叹息，而是他想到你们，他就喜乐。
And so what this could refer to is that when they're doing the shepherding task, let them do the shepherding task with joy. When they think about the sheep, when they think about our members, let them do this.With a joyful heart, not a sad heart.
那另外一个就是有一天他们交账的时候，如果弟兄姐妹是跟这个传道人一起合作，彼此相爱，我们为这个教会好，一起努力的时候，那他在神面前交账的时候，他也是喜乐的交账，不是吗？
The other way to take this is that this refers to the accounting before God.So that if the church is working together, if the church is in harmony, then that when the church, the pastor and the sheep appear before God, this will be a joyful occasion.
所以接下来他说，你们要使他们交账时候有快乐，不致忧愁。
And he says, that's why he says, he has let them do this with joy and not with groaning.
所以英文翻得很好哈，那个不是忧愁，是叹息。
Okay, the English translation is pretty good. It's groaning.
所以呢，就说呢，我们教会的传道人每天来上班的时候，我们想到这个，我不知道朱牧师跟金牧师还有我自己，你们开到这个教会的时候，越往目的地近的时候越喜乐呢，还是越往目的地近的时候心中充满叹息？
Yeah, this is a
rhetorical question.
Thank you. It's a rhetorical question. It's with joy, if you want to know. I ask the pastors as they drive to church, do they drive to church as they get closer and closer to the church? Do they have a sense of joy or is it a sense of dread?
但是我知道在很多的地方有一些牧师他们真的是非常的不幸，他们不仅是带着叹息开着车走向教会，他们是带着恐惧开着车走向教会。
I know some. This is some churches where it's very unfortunate where the pastor not only comes drives to church, he groans, but he's petrified.
他想到教会那些会友，他就怕了。
When he think about the brothers and sisters of church, he's terrified.
但是感谢主，我们教会不是这样的一个教会啊。
Thank the Lord, our church is not like that.
但是呢，这个是我们一直要努力的目标，就是我们要有一个彼此合作的精神。
But this is something that we have to strive for. This is something that we have to work for.
我们一定会有意见的不同，我们一定会吵架的。
We will definitely have disagreements. We will definitely have even fights.
但是呢，我们的最终的目标是要让这个教会是一个可以让传道人可以以喜乐的心在这里服侍弟兄姐妹，以喜乐的心在这里一起。跟传道人一起合作，这样的话呢，将来我们一起交账的时候，我们都有好处啊。
So, but let us build this church to be a church where the ministers, those who minister here, do this with a joyful heart. As we do this, at the one day of reckoning, we will all be blessed.
因为呢，他在下面说，若忧愁的话呢，跟你们也没有好处啊。
Because look at the last phrase, he says, for that would be, even if the minister does this with groaning, that would be of no advantage to you.
所以呢，这个你的领袖，你的牧者在这里不快乐，不愉快，这个对你自己也是没有好处的。
And so if the pastor is groaning to his ministry here, this is no benefit to you as well.
因为一个心态健康的传道人对一个教会是非常重要的。
Because a pastor who has a very healthy heart, healthy heart is a very big blessing to the church.
所以呢，在这样的一个健康的环境当中，我们可以彼此的提醒，彼此的勉励，彼此的鼓励，我们彼此的成长。
And because in this kind of environment, we can mutually encourage each other, mutually build up each other, and mutually be a blessing to each other.
所以这个是希伯来书他在第十七节他所说话的这个目的。
And so this is the purpose that he gives to us here in verse 17.
所以我们要有一个长远的目标来看我们彼此之间的关系。
And so we need to have a long range view to see our relationship between one another here.
不仅是现在，而且有一天在神面前交账的时候，我们这个关系是不是可以带着喜乐的心交在上帝的面前？
And so it's not only here, but also when we appear before the throne of God, the judgment seat of Christ, can we have this joy as well?
另外一个我想顺便的提一下，就是我们要尊重一个教会的传统。
And the other thing we need to, I need to bring up is we need to honor the tradition of the church.
所以呢，当你来到一个教会的时候呢，每一个教会都有教会自己特定的传统。我想，我们不要把自己的一些想法带进来，造成这个教会的很多的一些这个问题。
So we also, at the same time, we also need to honor the tradition of the church. We should not bring a lot of our own thinking to the church in order to bring problems.
我举两个例子啊。
Let me give two examples.
因为王牧师当初设立的教会，他有一个目标，就是这个教会是超宗派的。Interdenominational.
Okay. When Pastor Wang established his church, he established his church as an interdenominational church.
好，我是长老会的。
I'm Presbyterian.
我真的不觉得。滴水跟泡水没什么差别。
I really think there's no difference between sprinkle and dunking in the baptism.
但是呢，我们的教会那个王牧师是浸信会背景的。
But our pastor Wang is from the Baptist background.
所以呢，他很看重洗礼是要浸在池子里的。
And so he really sees the importance of baptism immersion.
那如果我是长老会的，我就来跟王牧师吵说，你干什么花这么多钱弄个池子，不就滴滴不就行了吗？
I could be, you know, I could use my Presbyterian background says, you know, Pastor Wang, why do you want to waste so much water? Just sprinkle a little bit on the head, that's all.
所以我为什么要用这些不重要的问题来造成教会领袖的忧伤跟叹息呢？
Why would I want to use these little trivial matters, not important matters, and make this a point of contention in our church?
另外一个就是燕玲她所留给我们的一个非常好的榜样，就是其实我们教会里面有很多有属灵恩赐的弟兄姐妹。
The other thing is our sister Yanling, she gave us a good example. In our church, we have a lot of gifted brothers and sisters, spiritually gifted brothers and sisters.
但是呢，他们尊重这个教会的传统。
But they also honor the tradition of our church.
所以，当他们行使他们自己属灵恩赐的时候，他们是遵照保罗的原则，是在私下的场合来施行他们属灵恩赐的。
So that they, certain brothers and sisters, they limit themselves in the use of their spiritual gifts.Not in the congregation of our church, but privately.
你从来没有看过燕玲在公开的聚会讲方言，对吧？
You've never heard our sister Yanling open assembly speaking in tongues.
因为她尊敬这个教会的传统。
Because she respects the tradition of our church.
她不要让这个东西带到教会来，造成这个教会的一些问题。
She did not want to bring this into the church to cause the problem in our church.
我们教会有另外一对夫妇也是这样子的。
There's another couple who's like that in our church.
他们十几年来，他们早上去神召会聚会。
So in the morning, they always go to Assembly of God, for service.
但是呢，他下午来到这边。
But in the afternoon, they come to our church.
他在神召会的时候呢，他可以照他自己喜欢的方式敬拜。
And so in the Assembly of God service, this couple worship in a manner they like.
所以呢，但他到这个教会来说，你从来没有看过他指着你的鼻子说你要讲方言，你要讲方言。他从来没有这样过。
And but you never seen this couple, come to this church and tell everyone that you need to speak in tongues. You need to speak in tongues.
所以呢，我们就在教会里面，我们在这个教会，我们就可以看到很多弟兄姐妹，不仅是领袖，而且弟兄姐妹的榜样，他们如何的顺服在这个教会的权柄之下。
And so we see brothers and sisters here in our church how they submit to the authority of our church.
那同时我们也要尊重，也要那个也要体认这些弟兄姐妹，他们是有这方面的属灵恩赐的。
But we, at the same time, we also need to respect and honor the fact that these brothers and sisters have these gifts.
另外一个就是接下来他提的，我们是不是有为我们的牧者祷告呢？
The next thing he brings up is, do we pray?For our shepherds.
因为他在第十八节、第十九节，他提到两次说，请你为我们祷告。
Because in verses 18, 19, he says, "Pray for us twice."
所以呢，他第一次他说请你为我们祷告的时候呢，他求你求弟兄姐妹为他祷告呢，让他有一个无愧的良心，让他可以按正道而行。
Here, first of all, is verse 18 says, "Pray for us, for we are sure, so that we can be sure that we have a clear conscience." That's Desiring to act honorably in all things.
弟兄姐妹，我们需要你们的祷告。
Brothers and sisters, we need your prayers.
我们也是软弱的人。
We're weak.
我们有的时候也很可能会跌倒。
We can very easily fall.
所以呢，希望你们为我们祷告，让我们这些做领袖的人，让我们在这个教会所做的每一件事情是没有私心的。
Pray for us. That whatever actions we do, we can do this not.From a selfish ambition,
我让我们所做的每一件事情都是为这个教会的好处，为弟兄姐妹的好处着想而做的决定。
So that everything we do is not for motivated by our selfish ambition, but is motivated by the good of this church.
也让我们所做的是可以是正确的，是按是合乎真理的。
And what we do could be what is based on the truth, what is based on the truth of God's word.
然后在第十九节，你可以看到这个领袖他爱这个教会的心。他说：“请你为我们祷告，好让我赶快的回去，因为他在意大利之外的，他很有可能是在意大利之外的地方写的这封信。”
And he secondly in verse 19 he says that I urge you the more earnestly to do this in order that I may be restored.To you the sooner. It's this author is writing outside of Rome.
所以呢，他非常的想要回去看他们，所以呢，他请弟兄姐妹为他祷告，希望他可以早点回去。
So he really missed them, and he wants to pray them to pray for him so that he could be restored, so that he could return quickly to them.
保罗也做过几次这样的祷告。
And we know that Apostle Paul himself has written the same words many times.
他非常的想去罗马教会看一看。
He really wants to go to the Church of Rome.
所以呢，他请罗马的教会为他祷告，希望他可以去看他们。
So at the end of Romans, we see that Paul asked for their prayers so that he could visit them soon.
所以他讲完这一段之后呢，他就发出了一段祷。
And after he says, so after here, the author concludes this, he ends with a prayer and a benediction.
所以呢，在这二十节跟二十一节当中呢，在这个祷告跟祝福当中呢，我们看到两方面。
And in this blessing and this prayer, we see there are two truths.
第一个呢，我们看到的是说，我们祝福的时候，我们是。向一位什么样的神祷告，然后呢，让这位神的祝福临到弟兄姐妹。
First of all, when we pray, we see what kind of blessing that this God has, and what kind of blessing we want brothers and sisters to receive.
然后呢，我们可以看到这一位神是一位怎么样的神。
And secondly, we need to see, what kind of God this is.
所以呢，他一开始他说，但愿赐平安的神。
First of all, he began this benediction, says, "Now may the God of peace."
所以这个句你读起来你觉得没什么了不起的，你觉得很平常。
You know, when we come across this clause, we think there's nothing unusual about this clause.
但是呢，你如果你是一个被逼迫的一个基督徒，然后住在罗马，然后这位作者说赐平安的神，你的感觉是什么？
Now, Matt, but imagine yourself for a second that you are a persecuted minority Christian living in the city of Rome, where you were threatened with your own life. Now, think about again about this clause, now that may the God of peace. What kind of emotions does that give you?
神啊，我有平安吗？你真的是一位平安的神吗？
The Christians must be thinking, God, do I have peace? Are you truly the God of peace?
所以就让我想到，在耶稣最后的那段，在约翰福音那个非常漫长的告别的那段话当中呢，他说过这么一句话。
And I think about, you know, what Jesus said in his farewell discourse in the Gospel of John.
他在十六章三十三节说，我将这些事情告诉你们，是要叫你们在我里面有平安。
John 16:33 says that I've told you these things so that in me you may have peace.
然后接下来他马上说，在世上你们有苦难。
And then immediately he says, in this world you will have trouble.
但你们可以放心，我已经胜了这个世界。
But take heart, I have overcome the world.
所以换句话说，这个平安不是建立在一个你什么事情都很顺利的一个环境上。
So here you see from what Jesus says that this peace is not established in the absence of conflict.
所以呢，在这个平安呢，是说，就正是在你有困难，就正是在你苦难当中，正是在你生病的时候，你可以经历到的这个平安。
And no, this the peace that Jesus is talking about, and the peace that's being demonstrated here is the kind of peace that's given to you in the midst of sickness, in the midst of trials, in the midst of persecution.
我想在座有很多弟兄姐妹，你们都有过这种经验。
I think that every one of you have probably experienced this before.
在你生病非常疼痛的时候，
in the midst of the most painful illness,
在你非常非常哀伤的时候，
in the midst of when you're brokenhearted,
yeah,
okay,
非常悲哀。
when you're going through
in your deep
sorrow.
所以呢，在这样的时候呢，同时你却感到心中有一股莫名其妙的一股平静跟平安。
In the midst of that, you have this inexplicable peace dwelling with you at the same time.
就像台风的台风眼一样，在这个狂风暴雨中间，它是一个平静的中心。
Just like the hurricane, in the midst of a massive, powerful, destructive hurricane, there's the eye of the hurricane, which is peaceful.
所以当希伯来书作者说但愿赐平安的神的时候，他不是随便说的，他是勉励这些苦难中的弟兄姐妹，他们可以经历到上帝的平安。
And so when he says here that may the God of peace, he is not just saying this out of the blue. He is saying this directed to them, to the trials that they're going through, that they may experience this peace from God.
而且圣经当中的平安呢，它永远有一个末世层面的平安。
Thank you. But the peace that Scripture talks about always has an eschatological sense, meaning a sense that points to the future.
所以我们期待着那个最终的 shalom 可以临到我们的生命当中。
And so that we can have the shalom peace in our lives at this time.
啊，没有，在新天新地的最后的时候。
Okay, so we can experience that new shalom for the new heaven, new earth in our lives right now.
然后同时我们也期待有一天我们真正的会得到这个真正的 shalom 在我们的生命，在我们的社会，在我们的世界当中。
And at the same time, we have this hope that this is one day in the future, we will experience this peace in our lives, in our surroundings, in our world.
另外呢，这位神是一位什么样的神呢？
And also in another sense, what kind of God, another angle, what kind of God is this?
他说，就是那凭永约之血使群羊的大牧人我主耶稣死里复活的神。
Okay, this the order of this clause is a little different from the Chinese.
Yeah.
He says, "Who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep?"
在这里我们可以看到呢，我们的这一位神呢，他是一位用他自己的血成就救恩的神。
Here is also the following clauses by the blood of the eternal covenant. He established a covenant, eternal covenant with us by his own precious blood.
这个是希伯来书最重要的一点。
This is actually the central point of the book of Hebrews.
希伯来书的作者他花了很长的篇幅讨论耶稣的大祭司的角色。
If you think about what we got through, you know, he spent about the whole slew of chapters focusing on the high priestly ministry of our Lord Jesus.
他强调耶稣的大祭司，他有一个重点，就是在希伯来书九章十二节讲的。他说，这位大祭司呢，他不用动物的血，他是用自己的血一次的进到圣所。
And you know, this is something that the author of Hebrews emphasized over and over again. And we can see that actually in verse 12, that Jesus entered once for all into the holy places, not by means of the blood of goats and calves, but by means of his own blood.
然后呢，成了永远赎罪的祭。
And then the author says, thus securing an eternal redemption.
今天我们有一个名词叫做 life guarantee, 听过吧？
There's a popular phrase going around called life guarantees.
台湾翻作永久保固，中国翻什么？永久保险。好。
Chinese translated as eternal protection.
没有关系。所以这个永久保固，在这里我们就可以看到，耶稣的基督的救恩，它是一个 life guarantee， 它是不会过时的。
And here we see that the covenant that Jesus established for us, it's guaranteed eternally.
昨天晚上我进 Google key in life guarantee.
Yesterday I googled life guarantee.
然后呢，我看很多的这个公司，它 provide 那个，它提供 life guarantee。
I see a list of all these companies who provide life guarantees.
但是呢，这个 life guarantee 有一个 fine print， 有一个淡书。
But in every single case, there's a fine print.
他呢说，我们这个公司呢是提供 limited life guarantee， 有限的 life guarantee。
But in all the fine prints, they said all the life guarantees are limited.
所以呢，换句话说，听起来很好听，哇，一辈子的。
You know, so in other words, it sounds great, doesn't it? Life guarantee.
但是它前面一个 limited.
But we don't see the fine, small word limited.
所以等你真正要用的时候呢，它用各种的 fine print 告诉你，但是这方面你不能用，但是那方面你不能用，对吧？
But so when you actually need this life guarantee, the company will throw all sorts of conditions for this. It doesn't cover this condition, it doesn't cover that condition.
但是耶稣基督他用他自己的血所成就的救恩，他这个 life guarantee 是没有任何的 fine print， 他是永远有效，永远都有那个都可以用的。
But when our Lord Jesus, when He gives us His eternal, establishes eternal covenant by His precious blood, there's absolutely no fine print at all.
所以呢，我希望各位也可以用这样的角度来跟民间，我在中文部讲过，我要再说一次，用这样的角度来跟民间信仰的朋友来分享你的信仰。
So I would actually encourage many of you to use this angle about life guarantee to share the gospel with the friends around you.
特别是那些有民间信仰的 folk religion 的人。
For those who have folk religion.It's more targeting to Chinese.
因为他们非常，他们最大的障碍就是他们不能再烧香，他们不能再烧东西，他们不能再拜了。
Because a lot of Christians coming from that background, folk religion background, they struggle with the fact that they really can't burn paper money, burn paper things for their ancestors who have passed on.
你可以从这个永久保固的角度来跟他们讲。
And so, but you could share with them.From the angle of the life guarantee that we have in Christ,
你就跟他讲说，你为什么每到初一十五都要烧呢？你为什么要到庙里面要去烧这些东西呢
？You can ask them, why do you always have to burn paper money every January 15? Why do you have to go to the temple to burn these things for them?
我们以前也做过这样的事情，旧约。
We used to do this kind of similar things under the old covenant.
但是呢，今天呢，我们有一个永久保固的东西，这个是永远有效的。我们不需要在初一十五去烧了，这个东西永远都有效，不因为你烧了多少纸，这个才有效的。
But we have come to the place today where we don't We have an absolute guarantee of a covenant that lasts forever. This is not something that we need to burn over and over again.
好，然后呢，这位作者呢非常有意思，在整个的新约书信当中，只有这里用了牧者这个字。
No.
Yeah.
actually very interesting point is that in all the New Testament?
No.
Hebrews.
Besides Gospels.
Oh, besides the Gospel, this is the only place in all the New Testament where the word shepherd is actually used.
保罗从来没有用过.
Wow. The Apostle Paul never used the word shepherd.
名词.
As a noun.
对, 所以呢, 只有希伯来书在这里, 他们说耶稣是牧者。
This is the only place outside the Gospel where the shepherd is used. And here is used as Jesus as the shepherd.
而且是大牧者。
And not only shepherd, but the great shepherd.
所以我就在想, 为什么他只有在这里出现牧者这个字?
So I asked myself this question, why is this the only place where the word shepherd appears?
然后我在看教会的历史当中呢, 我发现牧者这个角色往往对受逼迫的基督徒是一个很大的安慰。
I realized as I looked through church history, the idea that the word shepherd, the concept of shepherd, is actually a great comfort to Christians who are undergoing persecution.
在早期基督徒, 他们在地底下, 在那些牧雀, 在牧雀, 在那些 catacomb 聚会的时候,
and so when the early Christians, when they're gathering, hiding among the catacombs,
你如果看墙上呢, 他们最常画的一个东西就是耶稣是好牧人。
And so if you look at the walls of the catacombs, the most common drawing, the most common illustration that is used is Jesus as a good shepherd.
你会常常看到, 常常出现。
You'll actually see this very often.
另外呢, 基督徒作家杨斐利, Philip Yancey, 他有一次到波斯湾去访问。
One time, Phil Yancey went to Boston? Boston?
Persian countries.
Oh, Persian countries.
Persian Gulf countries, sorry.
Oh, Persian Gulf countries, okay.
所以呢, 因为他不愿意讲名字。
Okay, okay.
就是呢, 他去那里访问的时候呢, 他访问一位穆斯林的女子。
And when he was interviewing one time, he actually interviewed one of the a Muslim young woman.
这位女子呢, 她后来信了耶稣。
And this Muslim woman later on became a Christian.
她为什么信耶稣呢?
Why did she become a Christian?
因为她在梦中, 她看见耶稣是一个牧人。
Because in her dream, she saw Jesus as a shepherd.
然后呢, 这个牧人呢, 不停地跟她说, 来跟随我, 来跟随我。
And the shepherd kept saying to this woman, come follow me, come follow me.
所以虽然家人逼迫她, 她受到很多身体上的伤害, 但是她说, 因为这个牧者的召唤, 她不能不跟随。
And so even though she goes through so much pain, so much persecution, ostracizing by her family, but because of what Jesus has said in her dream, because of what she said, I cannot but follow the shepherd.
在这样的逼迫当中, 因为这位大牧人, 他要跟着这个牧人走。
And so this in this persecution, the sheep want to follow the shepherd.
所以呢, 我们的神是一位平安的神。
So our God is a God of peace.
我们的神是一位用他的血来成就救恩的神。
And so, and our God is also the God who actually established an eternal covenant by His blood.
然后这个是永远有效的。
And this is a covenant that is guaranteed for life, eternal life.
然后我们这位神呢, 他像牧者一样的来看顾我们，引导我们。
And this God is also a God who actually shepherds us like a good shepherd.
那这样的神对我们有什么期望呢?
And so, what does this God, has appealed to, want from us?
这个也就是在二十一节所说的。
And so this is what the answer is here in verse 21.
也就是我们今天的结论, 我们有这样的一位神, 我们身为一个信徒, 我们应该做什么?
And this is our conclusion here. So if we have, as a believer, what should we do?
他这里说, 在各样善事上成全你们, 叫你们遵行他的旨意, 又借着耶稣基督在你们心里行他所喜悦的事。
Here he tells us, he says that Christ has equipped us with everything good that we may do his will, working in us that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
在这里呢, 遵行他的旨意, 跟借着耶稣基督行他所喜悦的事, 应该是平行, parallel的两件事情。
Okay. Equipping you with everything good that you may do his will, and working with us, that which is pleasing in His sight, should be paralleled.
他们两个其实是在讲同样的事情。
They're actually talking about the same thing.
然后这个是神所喜悦的。
And this is something that God delights in.
然后这两件事情在我们明年要讲的罗马书十二章两个综合在一起了。
And this passage really parallels to what we'll be preaching next year to Romans, in Romans, especially Romans 12.
对，因为所以呢，在十二章那个。保罗说呢，我们要把自己献上，当作活祭，是圣洁的，是神所喜悦的。同样的字。
Romans 12, 1 and 2 says, I appeal to you, brothers, as by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, which is pleasing in His sight. The same exact words used here in Hebrews.
然后说，不要效法这个世界，要更新变化，要查验神的可喜悦的旨意。
It says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may know His will.That which is pleasing and acceptable to Him.
所以在这里呢，希伯来书的作者勉励弟兄姐妹说，要行神所喜悦的事。
And so the author Hebrews here tells us to do what is good and what is pleasing in sight.
所以呢，这个喜悦的事是什么事情？
What is that thing that is pleasing in sight?
其实这个喜悦的事情，你再稍稍往前看，在前面已经讲得很清楚了。
And actually, we know what is pleasing is something that has actually been mentioned beforehand.
因为同样的字在第十六节，不是同样的字，动词是在十六节出现的。
The verb actually occurs in verse 16.
所以他在十六节说，只是不可忘记行善和捐书的事，因为这样的祭是神所喜悦的。
It says, "Do not neglect to do good." And to share with what you have for what such sacrifices are pleasing to God.
所以呢，什么是神所喜悦的事情？
So what is pleasing to God?
行善。
It's to do good.
然后第二个，中文翻成捐书，英文翻成分享。
对。
所以呢，就说我们要成为一个愿意分享的人。
And so the second thing that's mentioned is to share. So we need to share with what we have.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们在这个群体当中，我们要记得约翰一书所说的话。
So as we're here together, let's remember what the Apostle John mentioned for the Epistle of 1 John.
他说：“小子们呐，我们相爱不要只在言语跟舌头上，总要在行为和诚实上。”
He says.Little children, let us not love only by words only, but let us love in deeds and in truth.
因为呢，在第十五节，希伯来书作者说，你们要以颂赞为祭献上，对不对？
对。
希伯来书十六章，十三章十六节。
Right. It says, "Do not," because it says, "Don't neglect to do good."
不是，十六节说以颂赞为祭。
十五节吧。Do him, let us continue to offer up sacrifice and praise to God as a fruit of lips.
哦，对不起，十五节，对。
That acknowledges his name.
我的数字白痴又发作了啊！所以 OK， 所以呢，在前面他讲的是以颂赞为祭。
So here in verse 15 it says the sacrifice of praise that God offered to God.
你这个只是用嘴巴的。
This is just something you just say with your mouth.
但是约翰说，你不可以只在言语上。
But did we remember what we just said about John? John says, "Do not love each other by words only."
所以接着十六节，希伯来书作者马上说：“你们要行善，你们要把你们所有的分享出去。”
So immediately in verse 16 it says, "Do good and share with what you have."
所以最后，希伯来书对这个教会的勉励，对这个群体的勉励，就是你们要做一个慷慨的人。
And so what the last appeal he gives to us is that we need to be a generous person.
特别是在这样的一个时代，我觉得作为一个慷慨的人会成为一个非常非常美好的见证。
And especially in this kind of society, the times we live in, I think a generous person is a great testimony.
Timothy Keller 写了一本非常好的书，有关这个主题。
Tim Keller wrote a really good book with this title, about the subject.
Generosity.
所以呢，
你们可以去看那本书，它有很实际的建议，告诉你我们为什么要做一个慷慨的人。
And that's a very good book for you to look if you want to learn what it means to be generous.
这个也是保罗在哥林多后书他想要分享的。
And this is also something he wants to share in Second Corinthians.
保罗在哥林多后书他说，我们的耶稣基督他本来是富足的， 但是呢，他愿意甘愿贫穷。
It says, Second Corinthians, it says, consider our Lord Jesus, who was rich, but for your sake became poor, so that you might through his poverty become rich.
弟兄姐妹，耶稣基督来到这个世界上，他甘愿从天上降到世界上，成为一个凡人，是出于他的慷慨，是出于他的宽大，是出于他的爱心。
And so we see the grace of our Lord Jesus when he became a man at the incarnation. He did so out of his lagus of his heart, out of his generosity, and out of his love for us.
所以弟兄姐妹，在这个救主降生的日子，让我们再次的反思自己，让我们的爱心不要只表达在我们的嘴巴上。
And so let us, as we come together, as we come upThis time of incarnation, let us remember that we should not just demonstrate our love through our words only.
让我们在行为上表现出我们的爱心。
Let us through our conduct also demonstrate that love.
分享我们的爱。
Sharing our love.
分享我们的金钱。
Sharing our money.
分享我们的时间。
Sharing our time.
然后呢，在这个教会当中，我们彼此帮助，彼此成长。
So that we can help each other and grow together.
这个是希伯来书的作者对罗马的教会，对罗马的这群信徒的期望。
And so this is the last appeal given, by the author of Hebrews to this church in Rome.
所以也希望米城教会，我们每一位，我们也都可以成为一个慷慨的人。
And so that I pray that you know our church will also be a generous.Church.
这个跟教会奉献的多少是没有关系的。
I'm not talking about offering.
因为这个金钱的奉献是慷慨的一部分，不是说因为这个教会少了钱你要奉献，而是你本来就应该要做一个慷慨的人的。
This is a generous, because generosity, tithing is only a part of generosity. It's, I'm not talking about money here. I'm talking about the fact that we will be.The fact that we are generous, of course, we will part of it. We will tithe.
保罗说，马其顿的教会非常非常的穷，但是呢，当他们知道要捐钱给耶路撒冷的时候呢，他们说也给我们也让我们有份吧。保罗说，你们这么穷，你们不要捐了。他们说，我们愿意捐，我们愿意捐。
Just like what Paul says to the Macedonian church, the Macedonian church was a church that was in the throes of poverty.But yet, they wanted to be part of the ministry of giving to the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul actually even told them that they do not need to give, but they want to give of themselves.
所以求神帮助我们，让我们成为一个慷慨的人。
So I pray that God will help us to make us generous people.
因为我们的神是一位慷慨的神。
Because our God is a generous God.
他甚至将他的独生子拆到这个世界上来。
He even sent his only son into the world.
我们的这点钱算什么呢？
Well, compared to this, what is our money worth, really?
所以我想今天的回应诗歌，我想改变一下，我们来唱Wondrous Cross.
So I would like to make a change for our response song. Let us sing the Wondrous Cross.